In the last unit, we defined the term unit cell. In this unit, we will get acquainted with the seven crystal systems. But first of all, we will further characterize the unit cell. The unit cell of a crystal is something that will build the whole crystal if you translate the unit cell along all three space directions again and again. Such a unit cell is characterized in the first instance by its so-called metric. The metric are the lattice parameters, and we need six of them to unambiguously define its dimensions. First, the length of the edges A, B, and C. By definition, A is running along the x-axis of the coordinate system, B along Y, and C along Z. Second, the angles between these edges or faces. Alpha defines the angle between edge B and C, beta is the angle between A and C, and finally gamma is the angle between A and B. Another attribute of the unit cell follows directly from its definition, and this is related to the symmetry. The unit cell contains all symmetry elements of the crystal. This can be expressed also the other way around, in the following scenario. If you choose a certain piece of a crystal as the unit cell and you apply the definition of the unit cell as we just learned, meaning you translate this unit cell along all directions. If then suddenly a symmetry element appeared that was not in your initially chosen unit cell, then you would have chosen a too small piece of the crystal as the unit cell. And this means in turn, the symmetry aspect defines in a way the minimum size of a unit cell. From the definition of the unit cell, one further attribute follows, namely regarding its chemical composition, or the stoichiometry, as the chemist says. The chemical content of a unit cell corresponds to the chemical composition of the considered crystalline compound. Assume, for instance, our crystal is composed of water, H2O. Then the ratio of the chemical elements hydrogen to oxygen is 2 to 1. And this must be true for the unit cell of the crystal as well. If the unit cell consisted of a chemical species HO, then the whole crystal would have necessarily the same composition, because the only thing allowed with this unit cell is to repeat it along all three directions. And that means an additional hydrogen atom would never add up to the HO. Only other HO units. Of course, the unit cell may contain more than one molecule of water, for instance 4, as long as the ratio of the elements is the same. Okay, and now we are going to classify unit cells. We already saw several possible unit cells with different shapes. Interestingly, the number of different unit cell shapes expressed by the metric is very limited. All the crystals of the world can be classified into not more than seven crystal systems. And these are the names for them, which you simply have to memorize. They are listed here roughly according to increasing symmetry. Triclinic and monoclinic, three times Q or only once. Orthorhombic, everything here should be orthogonal. Tetragonal, trigonal and hexagonal, and finally cubic. As already mentioned, they differ in the lattice parameters. And the following table presents an overview of exclusions and restrictions of the lattice parameters. So, let's have a brief look at some of the entries of this table. In the triclinic crystal system, there are no restrictions concerning the lattice constants and also no restrictions regarding the angles between the edges or faces, respectively. In the monoclinic crystal system, we also have no restrictions with regard to the lattice constants. However, the degrees of freedom concerning the angles is somehow restricted because two angles are fixed. They are determined to 90 degrees. In the orthorhombic system, all angles are determined to 90 degrees, as the name already suggests. The next three crystal systems are characterized by the fact that two of the three lattice constants have to be equal, and that all three angles are fixed to these values here. And finally, the crystal system with the highest symmetry, the cubic one, there are no degrees of freedom left. All edges must be equal in length and all angles are fixed to 90 degrees. You might think, there are 7 systems but only 6 different entries, because the values of the trigonal and hexagonal system are absolutely identical. That's right. And that is also the reason why sometimes it is said that there are 6 and not 7 crystal families. The trigonal and hexagonal system belong to the same, the hexagonal, crystal family. However, the classification according to crystal systems is based upon the symmetry. Here, in the additional column, the maximum symmetry of the crystal systems is displayed. And as you see, they differ for the trigonal and hexagonal system. Probably many of you do not understand these symbols yet, but you shortly will. As you will see, this table can be found in almost every textbook of crystallography. But you should be aware that in most cases it is displayed in an incorrect manner. Not the restrictions are tabled, but statements about the specific values of the cell dimensions and angles are made. Look for instance at the triclinic crystal system. The length of the unit cells should be allegedly all different and the angles too, and also unequal to 90 degrees. And this is simply wrong. These circled entries are wrong. Of course, it is not very likely that the angles are 90 degrees for the triclinic system, that's true, but it is not forbidden. The angles can be indeed coincidentally 90 degrees, even for the triclinic crystal system. And this means that the crystal system is not determined by the cell length and angles, by the metric, it is determined by its symmetry. Let us summarize this, as this is really, really important. I therefore call the following statements VIMS, very important messages. The cell parameters give only an indication of the underlying symmetry of the unit cell. It is not the metric which determines the symmetry. It is exactly the other way around. The symmetry determines the metric, although not in an unequivocal way. The mathematic experts among us would say not in a biunic way. Crystals, which belong to the triclinic crystal system according to their symmetry, may have coincidentally cell parameters like this. A equals B equals C, and alpha equals beta equals gamma, and all are 90 degrees. And vice versa, a crystal of the cubic crystal system has necessarily, and due to the symmetry, always these cell parameters. Okay, let's deepen our knowledge and try to deduce the crystal system from given unit cell parameters. We will do one exercise together. Further exercises can be found in the accompanying quizzes. An analysis of a crystal gave the following unit cell parameters. A equals B equals 12 angstroms and C is 12.1 angstroms, and all angles are 90 degrees. And the question is now, which of the different crystal systems could this crystal belong to? And now we have a look at the table again and we see the following. The cubic one doesn't fit. All cell constants have to be the same here. This is not the case for our crystal. The hexagonal and trigonal system can be excluded as well because there is the gamma angle. In our case, it is 90 degrees and not 120 degrees. So, what about the tetragonal system? Oh yes, I think that fits. A equals B and all angles are 90 degrees. Going on to the orthorhombic crystal system, well, that fits too. If none of the cell constants are fixed or determined, then they could also have the dimensions of our crystal. The angles should obey 90 degrees and this fits perfectly well. And finally, the values are also compatible with the monoclinic and also with the triclinic crystal system. So, the right answer is it can be tetragonal, it can be orthorhombic, it can be monoclinic or even triclinic. And this means, with this given unit cell parameters, we can't say more. It can be one of these 4 crystal systems.